Remember me?
Yeah.
Hop in, I'll give you a lift. Your mother told me I'd find you at ballet school. Actually, I want to have a bit of a chat. You see, we're trying to find out who's been making these calls and things, and you wouldn't have any idea who it is that's been calling your uncle, would you?
We're just a nut, but...
Well, we just wanted to make sure. You got many friends, Jennifer?
Not many.
The schoolmates? How about ballet school? Any friends there?
Uh-huh. You're a bit of a loner, eh?
Oh, so am I. I find people pretty hard to take at times, but on the other hand, I reckon you need someone to talk to now and again. You can't be on your own all the time. You like movies? Music? I like Blood, Sweat and Tears. I reckon they're terrific. And Cat Stevens. And I like jazz. Miles Davis.
He asked me about the phone calls and all that. Then he got just sort of chatty. Gave him the big A.
Socks.
He's not a bad guy. Just that I was in a chatty mood. Had a hell of a day.
Why, what happened?
All that ballet stuff, it's too hot. Mum, do you think I could give it up? For a while, I mean. I need a bit of a rest. Do you think you could talk Uncle into it? Please, Mum.
No. I'm sorry, darling, but you can't throw 2 years' work down the drain. I know it's hard. Ballet is hard work. Requires a bit of a sacrifice.
But, Uncle, it's hot.
I know, love, but you got to put up with things like that. I'm hot, too, out there in the surgery. When you grow up, you'll be glad you have an education. To be a lady. It'll pay off then. Oh, by the way, I forgot to tell you. Tonight, the president of the AMA is coming to dinner. And, well, I would like to make an impression. Think of something brilliant for dinner. Sorry about the late notice. I'd like you to be there, too.
I've had it, Winston.
Look, Socks, you can't just up and go like that. Think of your mum.
I think of Mum. That's why. He's driving her up the wall.
Okay. But you've got to go about this the right way.
I am. I'm going to nick off. I'm going to get myself a job. Then get Mum out of that rat hole.
What sort of job?
In a shop. As a model. Anything. There are thousands of jobs.
Wrong. You're too young. Your uncle's got you under his thumb. Listen, you've had it, right? You want out. But you've got to do things properly.
But how?
Just leave it to me. I'll think of something. You go home, back to bed, and be a good girl, and say I'm sorry.
And back to the ballet and the French and the art and the speech lessons and all that. So, I can speak beautifully and move with grace, and he can show me off to all his smarmy friends and have me perform like a circus seal. I don't want to be a lady, Winston. I want to be a person. I hate private lessons. I want to go to a normal school and meet people like everyone else.
You will. You will.
Yes, I keep saying that. I hate him. He's got sticky hands when he touches me. I hate it. It's like snails crawling down your neck. I like the old times. That was fun, Dad. A bit of a rat bag, like you, but terrific. He talked to me like a person, about boats and things, good things. Mum was happier too. We were all happier. I'm going to have a nervous breakdown, I mean it.
Hey, you believe me, don't you? Everything's going to be all right very soon, I promise. Okay? Okay? I'm going to fix everything. I'm magic, remember? Now do as I say. Go back. Act like nothing had happened, not a thing. Take the rap. Just for a while. And then, magic.
You don't have to tell me where you've been if you don't want to. But I'd feel better if you would.
I'll tell you, but you must promise you won't tell him.
I promise.
I went to see Winston.
Is that all?
Yes. I just felt like seeing him to have a chat.
How is he?
Good. Good. I told him about things. He said it'd be okay soon.
Did he?
He said it'd fix everything.
Good old Winston.
But, Mum.
What?
I just had a terrible thought. You know Winston, he's beautiful, but he's mad.
Yes. Well, what's he done?
Nothing. Mum, I think all those phone calls to Uncle, I think it's Winston.
Did he say that?
No, but it sounds like him.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
What he said was he'd fix things up, soon. Fix things up. The person who calls says he's going to knock off Uncle.
Oh, come on.
And it's all my fault.
Sammy, where are you?
Here, Patrick. I'm coming. Socks is back. She's all right.
Where is she? Where have you been? What time she get back? What time? What time? You've been out all night. Where?
It was hot. I couldn't sleep. So I went for a bit of fresh air, a walk.
Walk? What walk? You better tell me the truth or else...
I told you, Uncle.
Don't you dare to walk away from me like that. Right, you don't want to tell me. I'll get the police to question you. You'll be examined by a doctor. Right.
Sorry about the intrusion. I found the door open and...
Come right in.
Well, I'm glad to see that Jennifer's back. Looking well.
Oh, yes. I didn't know myself. I just got back. I was going to ring you.
Oh, no need to now.
She went out for a while, for a bit of a walk. You know what kids are like. Sorry about all the trouble.
No trouble. Well, I better get back.
Hi, sorry I'm late. Three of my regular clients turned up. I couldn't disappoint them, could I?
Marcia's a couple of close friends of mine, Tracy and Gary.
Hey, Rivery, my neighbour would need a massage. Do drop in. First one's free. Oh, I'll give him all the massages he needs, thanks. Oh, just my luck. Hey, haven't we met before? Oh, I don't think so. I never need to visit the parlours, do I, darling? No, it'll come to me.
You said something about a message for me, though.
Yeah, I couldn't speak to you on the phone. Old Bob swears we're still being bugged. I knew I'd remember.
You got me intrigued.
Stuart Home College, Brisbane. That was a long time ago.
Are we going to be let in on this?
You're Trace Bishop and you won the school title Sportswoman of the Year. I wanted to win it my year, but I was expelled for being in the locker room with the maths teacher. Mr. Martin. Oh, still sees me, Randy, old devil. What was I saying?
You were saying something about a message for me, though.
Yeah, a client of mine was asking if I knew anyone interested in doing a special job. I told him about you. He wants to meet you.
Yeah, okay.
I mean, you could be a cop.
Well, you never know.
Oh, no way. If he is, I've got enough on him to really upset his little apple cart.
In what way?
He likes the same things that you do. No cop wants that to come out, does he?
Yeah, well, I'm pleased. How long have you known him?
Oh, about a month. Says he's from Albury. Down here on business, he said. I tumbled he wasn't straight right away.
Tell me about him.
Something big going on here, isn't there?
Yeah, well, you needn't worry your little head about that. In any event, you're going to be very well paid.
Yeah? What do you want to know?
So you've done some time in Pentridge, eh?
Yeah, got a drag for possession. There's talkers in a couple of bank jobs, too.
Ooh. Well, you tell him to meet me at VFL Park tomorrow afternoon. Here's two tickets.
How do you know?
You'll be with him.
Oh, tomorrow's my busy day.
It's all right. Mike will look after you. You run along. Get that message to Truscott as soon as possible. All right?
Okay. See you at the footy.
Well, I don't trust the little cow.
She's my worry.
I don't agree. Well, it'd be all right if you were just shacking up with her, but if we keep using her to do things, she's eventually gonna put two and two together.
No, she's not that clever, but she is useful. Once she makes a definite contact, then that's it. Look, we'll have a look at this bloke Truscott. If he checks out, we could be out of Melbourne in 2 days.
Heads.
Well, that settles it then.
Don't be silly, you take the devil.
No, fair's fair.
Has anyone ever told you you're stubborn?
Lots of people. Many times. Muss it up.
It's probably Amy Trusker.
Do it. Right, get in the bed. I'll go. Take your top off.
Hi. Truscott here?
No, but, come in.
Hi.
Hi.
I hope I'm not interrupting anything.
No, nothing. We can't finish later.
Do you know where Truscott is? He said I could reach him here.
No, he's going to contact us in the morning.
Oh, I don't get cold on my account. Get back into bed. I'll be going soon anyway. Oh, you look so lovely together. Well, it's obvious you two want to be left alone, so if you could tell Truscott he's taking me to the footy tomorrow, they're the tickets.
What time?
I didn't say, we're just to be there. Well, have fun, you two. Well, if you can tell Truscott to ring you about noon, I'll be awake then. Well, bye.
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 Jamie boy, but I told him he could stop over for a while. Just crash on the floor, you know?
Yeah? Did I?
Yeah, well, not permanently or anything. Just for a while. Just till he finds somewhere else.
First, we'll take the cash register. Now, when you make a sale, you ring the amount up, right? There's dollars. There's cents. Pull the lever. Put the money in, and if there's any change to give, take it out. Got that?
You've got 15 minutes drive from here. We should be there and back with no problem.
Well, I've got a light afternoon. I don't mind being a bit late.
Oh, who's that?
What? Sister Jeffries.
No, the other one.
Dr. Holland. He boards with me.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, pay attention. Pay attention. Now, if you want to take anything out of this without ringing up a sale or anything, you just do what I did, you know, pull the lever like that. But you mustn't push any of these if you haven't made a sale, you know, if you're not putting money in. Otherwise, I'm going to be out of pocket, you know, at the end of the day. My balance won't show right.
Oh, can I try?
Yeah, oh, wait a minute. Here's your first customer. This is my new assistant, Gail, Mrs. Gordon.
Hello.
Hi, what'll it be?
Well, I've already phoned down his just sandwiches, but I'll have a coffee. Yeah.
Oh. There's the sandwiches. There's the coffee.
It's 45 cents. Or 90 cents. How much for the coffee?
No charge for the staff.
Oh, great. I drink a lot of coffee.
It goes on my account.
Yeah, there's the account. Write it all in there.
Oh, I didn't get to use the register.
Your time will come, my dear. Now, listen, do you feel confident to be by yourself while I take my trolley around?
Sure, no sweat.
I wish you was up to change a $10 note for me.
What?
Yeah, and another thing
well
that you...
Well done. What's next?
Well, I'll leave you to it, Ada.
Yes, right, Dennis. Girl, there seems to be some money missing from the till.
Missing?
Yeah. $20 note.
Oh, yeah, I remember seeing it there.
It isn't there now.
Well, I wonder what would have happened to it.
I don't know, but Dennis said you changed a $10 note for him this morning. Now, you told me you didn't have any money.
I didn't tell you that. I said I couldn't afford a sandwich. That money was the rent I'd saved on my room.
Oh.
You don't think that I took the $20?
No, no, of course not, love. No, no, it'll turn up somewhere.
Now, look! It was on the floor.
Oh, what did I tell you? I told you to turn up. Oh, girl, look, I'm sorry if I sounded as though I thought you took it.
Oh, that's all right.
No, it isn't really. I'm really sorry. Of course, I didn't at all. I knew. Hello.
Hello. I won't be finished till about 4:45. So do you want to wait or go ahead and start?
No, I'll go ahead and start the tucker.
Right.
All right.
Now, you must be a terrific cook. Those recipes you saw on TV looked fantastic.
They were.
Now, can you really make all these things in this book?
Of course I can. I wrote it, didn't I? Yes, they're all beautiful. You want me to prove it, do you? All right, that's enough for three. Would you like to come and join us?
Oh, I couldn't do that, push to all that extra trouble.
Oh, come on, you've worked very hard. I bet you're hungry.
Oh, that's really nice of you. I'd love to. Thanks, Mrs. Simmons.
Okay, love, you're on.
Big hard boy, hit me or dare ya.
Right, stand over there on that line.
Well, blimey, paws off me.
You're going to learn to do as you're told, young lady.
Georgina Baxter, you've been sentenced to a period of 6 months imprisonment, having been found guilty of assault and bodily harm. Is that correct?
Answer when an officer speaks to you.
We better get you to the examination room. It could be broken.
Broken.
Don't worry. We'll see it doesn't ruin your looks.
Is that correct?
Right. See, she gets into a uniform, will you, Officer Barfield?
Hey, get into them, Rad. You try to put them on me, I'll scratch your eyes out.
Oh! Right, that does it. You're going to spend some time in solitary till you learn to do as you're told.
What about the showers?
Do you want to risk it?
No, thanks.
All right. Will you be all right? Mm-hmm. Better come with me.
Bunch of turds!
Up against the wall or you won't get any breakfast. I take it in, Miss Barfield.
Oh, what you got in there, Mr. Fletcher? A mad dog. Oh, good day, love. What did they shove you in?
No talking, Lizzie.
What are you staring at your bag?
5 minutes.
Don't you have any pajamas?
What?
Don't you have pajamas?
Huh? Oh, well, I'll get you some.
Yeah, where?
Can I have another biscuit?
Oh, sure, I've got myself.
Is that how you buy them, Bryant? With biscuits?
Yeah, that's right, Vera. You want a nibble?
You're disgusting.
Who are you calling disgusting?
Oh, don't
pay
any attention.
You want to see something disgusting? I'll bash your head!
I just wanted to thank you for everything you've done for me. I mean, if it hadn't been for you, I might have been as sick as bee.
Oh, didn't you, Matt?
Yes, you did. And not only did you look after me, you gave me that medicine. I might have died without that.
Oh, I wouldn't let that happen. You're my friend.
Yeah, I know that. And I care about you, too. I care about you more than just a friend. You know that, don't you?
You bitch! Oh, you dirty, filthy dyke! I thought you were my friend! You make me sick, you sick!
What's going on?
He kissed me.
All right, come on, outside.
Sick. Oh. Here's my hearing. What for? I can hear all right.
Well, we'd just like to make sure. You ever suffered from a severe earache or ear infection at all?
Nah, I've always been real healthy. Even when everyone was sick in here, I was okay.
So you don't think you're deaf at all?
What?
So you don't think you're deaf at all?
Nah, of course not.
Georgie?
I mean, there's no point in you mucking around the ears.
And so you're probably right.
Georgie, I was speaking to you and you didn't hear me.
What's up, love?
All right.
Where'd you get to this morning? We all wondered where you'd gone.
Hospital.
Hospital?
I reckon I'm deaf.
Deaf?
I've got to have an operation to fix it.
Oh, is that what's upsetting you? Fancy you being deaf.
Well, I ain't stone deaf. I've got what they call glued ears.
It's truth. And you never knew.
I've never been to hospital before.
Wendy, I thought you were going to buy yourself a new swimsuit.
Oh, my chickened out. Oh, but this one's side up, okay, see? I'm thinking about it.
You look cheery.
I am.
Wow.
That's all there is of it.
Hey, it's beautiful. You're going to look great in it.
As long as my blush doesn't clash.
Holy smoke. Now, come on, hold it up. It's truth, it's nice and skimpy, isn't it, eh?
Wally.
Yeah, well, there's not much material, is there? Still, she'll look okay on you, love. You're nice and skinny.
I think you better cool it, Wally.
I had enough trouble getting up the nerve to buy it.
Oh, no.
On the other hand. It's only you, Neil. You don't count.
Oh, no. What do you mean I don't count?
Morning, Wendy. Suppose you want to know what's on tonight's schedule?
Yep.
It's a special night. Samoan feast.
Sounds beaut. What do I wear, a grass skirt?
If you like.
Ah. Oh, I'll think about it.
They're great nights. You're lucky Alex is putting one on while you're still here.
Oh, don't remind me.
Oh, come on, Wendy. It can't be all that bad. Going home, I mean. Do you have a job?
I'm only helping Mum around the place. So dull. Nothing ever happens there.
Well, couldn't you do something with your writing? I mean, short stories, articles for the local paper.
Wish I could.
Come on, Wendy. You won that contest out of hundreds of entries.
Oh, it'd be different if I was trying to earn a living out of it.
Well, Matthew Kramer does.
Yeah, but look at him. I was brought up in the bush. If you can read, people look at you funny.
Even Matthew Kramer had to start somewhere, Wendy. It's worth a thought, don't you think?
Who the hell are you?
Oh, Angela said...
So you're the neophyte. The learner, the novice, the beginner to sit at my feet.
Yes.
You don't look old enough to be a writer.
I'm 17.
You're old enough. Come here.
You okay?
We were just having a chat about writing. Mr. Kramer knows an awful lot about it. Wendy, are you all right?
Sure. Shouldn't I be?
He didn't try anything.
Hey, Mr. Kramer.
Yeah.
Of course not. We're just having a good old yarn about writing.
I'm a bit worried about Neil, though. He does the strangest things at times.
Oh, hi, Wendy. Oh, I'm sorry I broke up your chat before with Matthew Kramer.
It's okay.
Come sit down. To tell you the truth, I had a somewhat different impression of him.
Yeah, me too. I thought he'd talk down to me being a big-time author, but he wasn't like that at all. Before long, we were nattering away like old mates.
Until I came in and messed it all up, I'm sorry.
Not to worry. I might get another chance to talk to him, and next time I won't have the jitters.
Tell me, was he any help to you as far as your own writing's concerned?
I thought I was hard done by, but he had to steal the paper to write his early stories on. If he had to do that, then I've got it dead easy. And he told me the real secret, to sit on my bottom and not to get up till I've written something I like.
Yeah, that's the stuff.
Maybe I imagined it. I am sort of young, but I think he was being really honest with me. I got the feeling with all his success and everything, he's not a very happy person. I wish there's something I could do about that.
The product is aimed at serious athletes, stressing technique and discipline.
So everything has to be believable.
Away you go. Good, good. Nice legs. And butterfly?
Butterfly.
Butterfly.
Butterfly across the carpet.
Please?
How about high diving? May we please have the butterfly? Okay. Not splashing you, am I?
You don't seem to be taking this seriously.
Oh, no, I'm always serious when I swim across the floor. You may go now. It's suppose I'll never work in this town again. Goodbye. I only just got here, too.
Thanks for the swim.
See you, gang.
Take hours to put it back together.
Depends how good you are.
Oh, yes, Mr. Modesty.
So how good are you?
Well, I was top apprentice in my year.
Oh, yeah?
It's true. I could rebuild one of these babies in record time. It's a wonder they didn't put me in the Guinness Book of Records.
Okay. All right, I'll organise it.
What?
The Guinness Book of Records.
Why?
I'll tell you how good you are. Come on, you're not going to chicken out of it, are you?
No, of course not.
This will be great.
We have an emergency. What is all this?
Look, it's a record attempt at engine assembly. What is it?
Chris just rang from Arugula. A man's been stabbed. Sam's going to meet us at the airport.
A woman in love.
We belong in different worlds.
A woman in trouble.
What's your relationship with Tom Walters?
A policewoman who finds her lover...
Don't lie to me, Tom.
...is a crim.
I didn't know the cars were stolen!
Now they'll use her.
We want you to talk to him.
Pressure her.
Are you a member of this force? Or do you dislike wearing the uniform?
Until she betrays the man she loves.
Don't do this to me.
Bankers Trust presents the movie-length premiere of a great new series.
Who else is there? Uncle John. What are you doing?
I'm looking at my bracelet.
Your bracelet?
I just got it.
What does it look like?
You know, if anyone else asked me that, I'd belt them one.
I wouldn't be surprised.
Do you got any idea what they expect you to do in those films?
Well, we needn't go into the details.
Bloody filth. They ought to have their...
All right, Jean, let's not get excited. I gather you haven't accepted any offers to star.
No, and I wouldn't want to get any either. You mightn't believe this, but none of the girls I know would touch it with a pole.
I believe that.
Right. Then I'll tell you something. Where they get their actresses from. Kids, mainly.
Well, we know that.
And housewives. Bored, stupid, suburban housewives. You don't believe me? Well, it's true. And they call us. I'll tell you another thing I hear. If you're looking for the top man of the operation around here, you're wasting your time. It's a woman.
What's her name?
Haven't a clue. Why don't you ask the boys who distribute the muck?
We'd been friends, you see.
wanted to go for a drive. For old times. We went to French's Lane. It was very quiet. She wanted me to make love to her. I couldn't. I mean, I wouldn't, not with her. She disgusted me. She always did. Teasing me. That's what she was doing. Teasing me. But
have a good day, Charlie.
All right.
What did you do?
Went to the pictures.
Oh, which one?
I don't remember what it was called.
A comedy, was it?
Yeah.
That's nice. I suppose that's why you're so late. Well, it's just as well I put your dinner in the oven. Did you pick up your pension?
Yeah. I'll give you me rent.
Oh, that's all right. Finish your dinner. You can pay me later.
Well, Marge, I was going to buy you a present.
Present? What for?
Your birthday.
Oh, it's not until next month. Anyway, you keep your money for yourself. You need it more than I do.
Don't worry, Marge. I can afford it.
Can you just? What did you do, rob a bank? Really, Charlie, you do take things so seriously.
Sometimes wish I had less money and more husband.
That'll be the day. You become too used to it.
What, money?
Hmm.
I hate it.
Mrs. Riley, I'm Senior Detective Peters, Yarra Central.
He spends most of his time looking for work.
Without success.
Well, he's hardly got very sought-after qualifications. But his pension doesn't go very far, so he keeps on trying.
Perhaps there's a way of catching up.
He's not very bright, Mr. Peters, but he does know what's right and wrong.
Perhaps he didn't think it was wrong.
He's not that simple.
Then?
You mean, why did he run?
It's usually some sort of indication of guilt.
With a normal person, yes. With Charlie, you've only got to suggest he's done something and he'll probably believe you. He knows he's got problems. But other people see things more clearly. So he believes them.
You think he'd admit to something he didn't do?
Accuse him of blowing up the town hall. See what he says to that.
No, Charlie, you're not with me. That man that came out in the yard before, you know the man that walked along the line you were standing in?
He's the man I robbed.
Are you asking me or telling me, Charlie? Have you ever seen him before?
Yeah.
When?
Yesterday.
Tell me what happened.
I bumped into him.
Yeah.
Then you hit him on the head and you took his money.
Yeah.
And then you took it somewhere and you hid it.
All right, Mrs.
Riley. Yeah, that's right.
Where did you hide the money, Charlie? In that cupboard over there?
Yeah.
There you are, Mr. Vickers. You'll find your money in the cupboard.
All right, Mrs. Riley, you made your point.
Not before time.
Oh, Scotty, could you send someone up, please?
We don't believe you, Charlie. And I don't think that's quite how you remember it.
Yeah,
what's the last thing you remember doing?
Going to the pictures.
The one at the junction?
Yeah.
And what was it about? He saw it all right.
Oh, Constable, I think Charlie here might like to have a look around.
Oh, come on, then.
Don't show him out the back.
Well, what was this business about the pictures?
Well, it wasn't Sound of Music.
Mrs. Riley, do you mind if we search your house as a matter of routine?
Do what you like. What about Charlie?
We'll see you get home.
Hello, Bluey.
G'day, Janie. How's tricks?
Been off my feet all day. It's getting hard to even raise a smile.
I can see what you mean.
Come now. See you later. Just take it.
You want the usual, darling?
Yeah, and I'll have a beer as well.
Beer.
I like your shoes. What time are you getting off?
Depends. You on duty?
I'm off.
Give me about half an hour.
Cheers.
Your place or mine?
Yours is closer. Cigarette?
How's the new job? First day, isn't it?
Yeah, first bloody day.
How about a dance, Blue? Let's strip the light, fantastic.
For you, Georgie, anything. Hello, love. You right for tonight? Yeah, I don't feel like going out. How about my place? No, I won't be able to make it for the weekend. Too much work on my plate. I'm really going to need a rest when I get back.
Hello? Rita? Oh, look, love, there's some people looking for you. They're the cops and someone else. I just had a call from Lou Kern.
You don't know who the other one was?
No. Lou had never seen him before.
I'd better get out, I suppose. Might go up north.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind joining you. That's if the pigs don't arrest me first. Yeah. Anyway, love, good luck.
Yeah.
Another tramp, a friend. Do you like the look of her?
Who are you?
You're going to end up in a place like this.
What do you want?
Hell, get an ambulance, my friend. Come on, Josie. Wake up, kid. Come on, Josie.
Detective Georgie, here, Riverside Police. I want an ambulance at the Bijou. Room 24. Yeah, right, thanks.
Josie, can you hear me, kid? You've got to tell us where we can find Rita Stevens.
Come on, Josie, we're police. It's all right. We've got an ambulance coming for you. You're going to be all right.
But you've got to tell us where to find Rita.
I rang about my father. Fred Sampson, remember? Mrs. Brown?
Oh, yeah.
I was worried that my father might do something stupid.
Yeah.
Well, he's done it.
Oh, you mean he's done something kinky?
No, the money's gone.
What money?
Nearly $20,000. I had a look in his passbook. It's his life savings. All gone.
$20,000?
Yes, and when I asked him what he'd done with it, he said he bought presents for his girlfriend.
Look, you've just got to stop worrying.
Excuse me, will you?
Can't help it. You must care a lot about him. I love him.
Please,
you're very lucky. Very hard to find a right man. Oh, have you finished?
Yes, it's all over now. We can go home.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Thank you.
Now, Mrs. Brown, are you sure about this?
Maybe he's been conned or he's lost it, or I don't know.
What, does he bet on the horses?
He doesn't drink and he doesn't gamble. He's just a stupid old man.
Yeah. Look, I'd advise you to go home, talk to him nice and gentle, you know, see if he'll tell you something else. If not, bring him in here and I'll talk to him.
Thanks very much. I mean, he nearly gets killed every time he crosses the street. He forgets to turn off the gas. He nearly burnt the house down once. He's a total disaster. Look at him.
Well, let me have a word with him.
I mean, what woman in her sane mind would even look at you?
I'll talk to you, Mrs.
He's been right off since Mum died, you know. He forgets to put his teeth in if I don't
I'll have a word with him, Mrs. Brown. Mr. Sampson, would you like to come round here? That's it. Here we are.
Do you know what's happened? Is Mr. Butler all right?
You talked to policewoman Francis, didn't you?
Yes.
I'll get it for you. Sit down if you like.
Thank you.
See, there we are, then. But who did you give the present to, that?
I bought it for my girlfriend. There she is. There's my girlfriend. Hello, Liza.
Hello, Fred.
Oh,
Mother, what are you doing here?
It's a nice way to greet your mother. I thought I'd come and see how you were.
Hello, Mrs. Baxter. How's the, shop?
I've Andrews told you I was here.
Yeah, well, you wouldn't have thought to let me know, would you?
Why should I? You'd never care what happened to me before.
And you haven't exactly been the loving daughter ever since I had you.
Happy families. Reminds me of when I was a kid.
Times have changed. Very posh.
No talking. Gee, Nancy Baxter, you've been sentenced to a period of 7 days imprisonment, having been found guilty of living off the earnings of prostitution. Is that correct?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yes, Mr. Fletcher.
Oh, whatever you say. You know, you look familiar. Haven't been visiting my establishment by any chance.
Over there, please.
Here, no need to rip it off. So you probably know my kid. I think they said she was in Wentworth. Yeah, that's right. Georgina. Sweet little girl. Spit in your eye as soon as look at you. Like mother, like daughter. Wouldn't you say, Mr. Fletcher? Times have changed. Very posh.
No talking. Gee, Nancy Baxter, you've been sentenced to a period of 7 days imprisonment, having been found guilty of living off the earnings of prostitution. Is that correct?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yes, Mr. Fletcher.
Oh, whatever you say. You know, you look familiar. Haven't been visiting my establishment by any chance.
Over there, please.
Here, no need to rip it off. So you probably know my kid. I think they said she was in Wentworth. Yeah, that's right. Georgina. Sweet little girl. Spit in your eye as soon as look at you. Like mother, like daughter. Wouldn't you say, Mr. Fletcher? I'll teach you to make a fool of me in front of those women. Cheap little tramp, you won't respect if I have
leave her alone!
Hey, if you ever come near Georgie again, I'll do more than box your ears and you get out of here. She is my bloody kid. I'll do what I bloody well please.
Oh, not anymore, you won't.
It's the only language she understands.
I said, get out of here!
Probably won't ever see you again. But I just wanted to say I'm sorry. I didn't realise you had a hearing problem all those years. Well, it must have been rotten.
Maybe if you'd had a little bit more time for me, you might have found out.
Yeah. Anyway, I'm glad it was a success, and now you can do anything you want to do. Don't waste your chances like I did.
At the end of your motherly advice?
Yeah.
Good. And you're right, you won't be seeing me again. You can look forward to a long, lonely old age. And when you die, it'll take them days to find you because there'll be no one around to care.
Don't suppose you'd change your mind and come and live with me when you get out?
Nah. We're only bright like we did before. I've got to lead my own life.
Yeah. Well,
I better be going.
Yeah.
Goodbye, Georgie.
Hey, do you reckon you can come and visit me? Let me know how you're going.
I'd like that. Bye.
Bye, Mum.
Mrs. Burns.
Tim seems quite calm now.
Yes, the ambulance will be arriving for him at 11. Nurse Hammond will accompany you to Sydney.
The matron said you were responsible for saving Tim last night and that you sat with him for 2 hours afterwards.
We don't have a respirator at the hospital, Mrs. Burns. He had to be watched carefully while the tube was in.
Oh, he's never been this bad. Seems to be getting worse.
Have a seat.
Just doesn't seem fair, does it, that he has to suffer like this?
Mrs. Burns, I know how much you love Tim, and it's natural that you worry about him. It's very distressing to watch him having trouble breathing.
Oh, I wouldn't wish it on my worst enemy.
All the attacks in the middle of the night, not knowing if it's going to stop, if he's going to pull through. Now, all this causes worry, anxiety, fear. Now, your worry, which is absolutely natural because you're his mother and you love him, can be transferred to Tim and cause the trouble. Do you understand that?
Are you trying to tell me that it's my fault?
Well, we mean well when we love somebody and we try to help, but we can cause a lot of damage. One of the big problems with Tim is that he thinks he's a cripple. He expects to have an attack the moment he's out running on the grass, and therefore he has one. Do you understand that?
Listen, I am very grateful for what you did for Tim. But really, you are just a nurse. I am his mother, and you don't know what it's
like. I do know, Mrs. Burns. My brother, Sean, was a chronic asthmatic, and my mother treated him, well, just the way you treat Tim. He relied on her for everything. Now, one day, Sean had a bad attack, and my mother wasn't around. And he died, Mrs. Burns. He died because he was allowed to think of himself as an invalid who couldn't survive without drugs or his mother.
I thought we'd said all we had to say this morning. If you've changed your mind about the wedding again, I'm afraid it's too late. I've already rung Gordon and told him David will be in touch.
No, everything's the same. David's made up his mind. It'd be a waste of time trying to get him to change it.
Then why are you here?
David doesn't know. He probably wouldn't like it.
There are just a few things I'd like to say to you before you go back to Sydney. Be my guest.
I'd never put my children's happiness on the line to get my own way. But I'm different to you. The only reason David's agreed to it being in Sydney is because he doesn't want to see Angela hurt anymore. So don't feel too smug. You don't give a damn about the wedding. All you want to do is get back at David and me.
You've really got quite a chip on your shoulder, Beryl.
I know I'm right. You've never got over the fact that he came back to me. That's your problem.
I could have given him a lot more than you. I still can. That's what really worries you.
Not anymore. You haven't got a hope of getting him back now.
Is that a challenge?
Everything has to be a fight with you, doesn't it?
There's no fight if there's no competition.
If it's competition you want, I've got 20 years of marriage. I'm carrying his baby. And he loves me. You haven't got a hope in hell against that. So I wouldn't waste my time trying. I guess that's really all I came to say.
Looks delicious, Alice. You'll have to give me the recipe.
Tony's favorite.
I can believe that.
Oh, my God.
Put the knife down.
How did you find us?
I said put the knife down. And now call the others in. the others in.
Tony! Alice, would you come in here, please?
No, I'm just waiting for the kettle to boil.
Now.
It's important.
You better not have dropped the cake or Mum will... Oh, hell.
Get in.
What happened? Don't tell me that you did...
Sit down, Alice. Both of you two, sit down. There.
I said sit!
That was delicious. My compliments to the chef.
Graciously accepted.
Have you heard anything from Jim recently?
No. I tried his hotel, but he'd moved out. Probably gone up north. He never does stay in one place for long.
No, I don't think he's the sort of man to make you happy, Beryl.
Oh, you don't think so?
No. No, I would have thought you'd prefer the steadier type. Someone who lived locally, who wasn't in the habit of straying too far from home.
I'll just get the dessert.
Oh, thank you. Subtle as a sledgehammer, aren't I? Someone who lived locally, who doesn't stray too far. You know, in front of a jury, I usually am able to find the right words to say. But in front of a woman, I do care for you, Beryl. I hope we can see a lot more of each other.
Stuart, I'm sorry. Excuse me.
I won't come in. I saw Kingsford's car out the front.
I've been ringing your hotel. I thought you must have gone to Queensland.
Oh, I moved to a cheaper pub. Look, I've been thinking about us a lot lately, Beryl, and I figure it's probably now or never. I want you to marry me.
Well, it's Shane. I couldn't possibly leave him.
Sudden change of heart, is it?
He's my son. Surely you can understand that.
It's a bit late in the piece, Lee.
Well, don't look at me. You brought it on yourself.
But I can't go to jail. You can't let them do that to Shane.
I remember when you couldn't have cared less about Shane.
Oh, that's been different for a long time.
But I've got a long memory, Lee.
So have I.
Well, don't forget one thing, Tim. If I go, you go too. You helped me put the birthmark onto Fuller. And with your record, you can bet your life they're not going to give you a pat on the head.
I see. Even turning on your brother now.
Are you sure you were telling me the truth?
If you came here to accuse me of lying...
It would be easy to make something like that sound worse than it was meant.
How dare you?
You have tried to cause trouble before, Doris, and I know you don't like me.
No, I don't like you. Everything was fine until you came along. I wish Rod had never laid eyes on you.
Then you did do it to cause trouble.
Yes. And I'd do it again if I got the chance.
Why? I told you I'm not trying to push you out of your job.
Do you think I went to all this trouble for a lousy housekeeping job?
You're in love with him, aren't you? That's it, isn't it?
Well, what if I am? It's got nothing to do with you.
He wants me to marry him.
He wants me. And he proved it the other night. It's true. You ask him.
I'm sorry.
I have to talk to you.
You've picked a bad time. Rod, David's picking me up shortly.
It'll just take 5 minutes.
All right.
I'm sorry I went up at the deep end last night. But if you're honest, I reckon you'll have to admit I did have a point. Because a marriage can't work unless people consider each other when they make decisions, you know?
Fair enough.
Oh, look, I've got to give an answer on this Mount Osborne job today. Now, I want to take it. What do you say?
I'd rather you didn't.
Because of David?
Partly.
Well, I think it's the wrong move, and you're taking it for all the wrong reasons.
Such as?
The money's the important factor, isn't it?
It's a factor, yeah. Why, is it a crime?
No. It just makes me feel uneasy. You want to make sure that you'll never be financially dependent on me. No. That's what broke up the marriage with David. I don't want us to go through that, too.
Look, you're already talking about us breaking up, and we're not even married yet.
I'm trying to be honest.
Well, I'm going to Mount Osborne. I'm going with you or without you.
Then it'll have to be without me.
You never had any intention of going in the first place, did you? Hey, you've just been stringing me along, haven't you?
That's enough, Rod.
What's the real story? Hey, you reckon you got a chance with your ex now his wife shot through, is that it?
Stop it!
You know what I can't stand? Hey! I can't stand the way you use your kid to get at him.
And I can't stand your constant fits of paranoid jealousy.
Yeah.
Don't you dare hit me. Get out, Rod, we're finished.
Very lucky woman. I have you, I have my son, and I have my home. I couldn't ask for any more.
Would it surprise you if I said I feel exactly the same way?